Okay, I'm gonna fire this first time with the ported barrel 45 ACP double tap derringer. And I wanna see how it compares to the upper barrel, because the barrels are not regulated. Regulated means both barrels are made so they hit the same point impact at a certain range, like double rifles. Very expensive to do that. These aren't. That's why I wasn't hitting the 50 in my second shot. I'm making 50% hits on this little derringer right here. So hopefully the bottom barrel will go first, I think. That's the one I'm gonna be setting the sights for. And then we'll see how the second one places compared to the first one. And see how the recoil is compared to the salt barrel. Okay. Okay, let me go up and take a quick peek at that one. Oh, that might have been the second barrel. See, the second barrel shoots higher, says 10 yards. Let me check and see. Well, I'll shoot the second round. I gotta check and see, make sure. I gotta know how these barrels fire. Nope, that was the top barrel. That's the one I'm concerned about. Okay, now I'll try the bottom barrel. At 10 yards, we're talking about. The recoil is significantly less with the ported barrel. Okay, these are new barrels. These ones shoot a little bit left, and they're both a little high, but the one is probably 5 or 6 inches high. I'll have to measure it. Wow. It is higher, but the standard barrel, I think, shoots a little tighter. I might switch them and mark those and shoot the standard barrel and feel the recoil difference. Yeah, that's definitely controllable. I got a glove on this time. That helps a little bit too. I haven't shooting before without a glove. So I'll fire two with the, I'll switch out the barrels and fire two with the straight barrel. Okay, now I'm gonna fire two with the non-ported barrel. See if there's that much difference. It sure felt pretty good compared to this one last time I shot it. So I'll fire two with this and see how this feels and shoots at 10 yards. Let me switch glasses again. That's better. Lighting indoors is the same as outdoors. Okay. Oh yeah, what a difference in recoil. That was the top barrel. That's even higher. So the other ported barrel shoots better. Okay then. All right. So the recoil reduction is significantly different with the ported barrel. Trust me, even with the glove on. I've been shooting my 9mm double tap and a straight barrel 45 without a glove on up to this point. But I might as well be comfortable in this circumstance where I'm going to be doing different shooting and stuff. So it looks like the two rounds of 10 yards are better with the ported barrel and lower. So let me try something else here.
Okay, let's see how it looks. The light's turned down. Okay, we're gonna fire two shots at 7 yards. I'll just fire one right after the other. The lowest one should be the bottom barrel. We'll just see here. Just point and shoot. Alrighty. Let's see, we got that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Two in the same spot. Holy smokes. Yep. I got two in the same hole. Because these, that was one of the first ones. No, that was with the upper barrel at one time. Then we shot these two. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's two shots right there. That's hard to believe. Let me try that again at 7 yards. I'll do two headshots. Let's see what the headshots do. I can't believe we're shooting this many rounds out of this thing. Yeah, these last two shots, they didn't catch it on the GoPro, had a lot. But they got it on the big camera. Two shots look like one hole at 7 yards. Let's try to go a little slower. Headshot at 7 yards. Right there, okay? Headshot. I got two in the same hole, but to the left. Holy smoky. I'm getting two in the same hole in the double tap. But I pulled it though. I'll try it one more time at 7 yards. They are shooting a little bit to the left. Hold on here. That's two and two holes here. One, two. Oops. One, two. Okay. Shooting a little bit to the left. But with this ported barrel and this glove on, it's not too bad. All right. Let's do it. Set our mass. Oh, okay. This one I spread them. One, two. I'm telling you, not too bad. This ported barrel is amazing. This is the double tap. Two barrels, ported barrel. The other barrel has no ports. You can see the ported holes here, hopefully in the light. This one has none. And I don't feel any of the blast because it's angled up. See, it's angled at a 45 degree angle. It's not straight out the side. So straight barrel is a significant difference. I can shoot this whole box of shells with this glove and this. I can shoot without the glove, just be a little bit less comfortable, of course. But this is a unique gun. I have been a cop forever, retired, carrying a gun forever. And every kind of gun that's ever come out, I've probably owned close to 200 guns, I'll bet you. I don't keep them all. Cop salary can't keep all those guns. You trade and sell, as new things come out. But I'm telling you, this is unique. And the nice thing about it is you have two extra rounds in the grip and in your pocket. You carry a speed strip. Now for you younger guys, you're gonna say what a speed strip is. Speed strip is something we revolver guys, wheel guns use years ago, because we didn't have speed loaders. We used to load, when I first started, I loaded out of my pocket. Even in matches. Speed strip, you put two in, and you strip them off. That's what's called speed strip. That broke one off there because I'm not paying attention. But that's what a speed strip is. And you have six there, two in there. But usually when you use this, you're not going to have time to reload anyway. This unique gun, when I was in the mid-70s, I had a high standard double Derringer 22 mag, and I thought that was cool. And that wasn't much smaller than this, if at all, 22 mag. And I used to carry that in my pocket. That little holster gun looked like a holster. You could put your finger through the leather, pull the trigger. This is a parachute gun. This is an airbag. Plane's going down. If you don't have a parachute, you die. But if you do parachute, it might hurt when you land. Airbag hurts when it goes off, but without one, you might die. Same with this. You only have two shots, the recoil's a little bit, but so what? You're more afraid of recoil or more afraid of dying? I know which one I'm more afraid of. I'm pretty recoil resilient. I have a 460 Weatherby's, I have a 458 Lot right now, I have a 500 Smith & Wesson. I've had 454 Casulas, 475 Line Balls, 4 different Magnums of every type. I'm pretty resilient. My first gun I ever shot ever when I was 14 was Model 29. Pretty old, I think it was called 5-screw back in those days. And my dad's hunting buddy let me shoot. He said, hey, you want to shoot this? And they thought I was going to drop it and be afraid. I didn't know to be afraid. Never shot a pistol before. Dirty Harry wasn't out yet. 44 Magnum to me was no different than a BB gun. And I shot it dead center. And no bragging, I didn't have a natural. I shoot well everything. Cameras, bows, darts, throwing knives, guns. And I can't help it. It just works out well. But this is cool because it's flat and nice and light. It's for those days you just don't have your gun with you. You're going somewhere where you're dressed super light in the summer. Or as a backup gun to the gun you have. If your gun fails or you can't get it out, that's the biggest thing that most civilians don't understand. Most people don't run up to you, say down there, hey, I'm coming to attack you. They pop out sometimes from here to there. You can't say they always pop out close, can't say they pop out far. You don't know. What I'm saying, in those instances where they do pop up close, anybody that close, that's why when I used to work the streets, if I thought a guy had a gun, a lot of cops stay back like this, I get here. Because nobody's getting the gun out of their pants if I'm here. They do that, rip your eyes up, draw everything else, disarm them. That's what they can do to you. And so getting your gun out of your holster, I don't care what kind of slick holster you have, I got my Glock 18 here. Little plastic holster here, that's nice. But it's under your shirt, that guy's neck close, time you draw and get up, he's on top of you. If you're in a bad area, you're walking back to your car, and if you saw my other video, I shot through my suit coat pocket. There's nothing to snag. It's in your pocket, boom, boom. So if you had it on your hand in your pocket, the guy jumps out, because all you want to do is get to your car, boom, boom. Through your suit pocket, if you need more, he gets 245s in the body. He's going to be changing his mind on what he's doing, and he's going to give you plenty of time to get back and get your gun out. Because to be able to engage, you have to get your gun out. So, that was a pretty good shot the last time. That was a little hot. But what I'm saying, when you can't get your gun out, it's up close and personal. This is a parachute. This is an airbag. This is a German Shepherd that's jumping over your shoulders getting a bad guy he didn't know was there. That's what this is. And I mean this bite baby bites. Big holes. This baby bites. Now you, people got little 25s, 32. Oh, they have more shots. If you can get to the more shots. At this range, you're lucky to get one shot off out of the guys on top of you. So if you get two in them, you're gonna have plenty of time to back up, take this gun or pop this out, put two more in. Take this, if you know you strippers, well, that's how we used to do it all the time, fast. We used to do whole revolver, two at a time. Shut it, boom, 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 boom. And see a lot of auto guys, let me just bring this up. A lot of you guys want to shoot autos, you always try to do everything, you keep it in your hand all the time, which is good for the auto. Pop it out, put it all in. But in revolvers, we can do that. We have to pop a cylinder up, put our fingers around the revolver, it's here, bring your reloads out of your pocket, put six in, shot it, put it back in your hand. You learn gun handling, switch gun, hands gun. And if you see me shoot the 19, I have it, boom, 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 almost in midair, shooting the other hand, boom, 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 I can go back and forth. And that's good gun handling, because in this thing, this is kind of like a revolver. You could go like this and try to reload like that. It might work, might not, because sometimes you gotta pull them out. If you're strong handed, if you went like this, it's easy to pull them out, strip them, close, and fire, like that. So you just do like that. So if it's a clean gun, the first two shots will fall right out. But if they're sticky, if you open it up, pop, pop, pull it out, jump, close, boom, boom, ready again if you're getting back up. So, but if you should put them down, you shouldn't be that close to them anyway. You should be running for cover. So I'm just saying, this is a unique gun. This much power packed in this small space. It doesn't shoot too bad. Like point shooting. All the ranges here I've just shown you, if it was me in the street tonight, I wouldn't be even trying to find these little sights. But it shoots pretty good. I can point shoot just as good. Matter of fact, shooting's better than talking. Let's say here, this range here, I better put some ears on, I'm gonna sure as loud. Ears and out. This thing's still recording. Yeah, it's recording. Good. I want to point shoot. I'm not even going to bring the gun up to my eye. I'm going to point shoot with one hand, baby. Let's see how it goes. Alrighty. One shot, two shots. Right in the upper chest. I'm not even used to this gun yet. So, I get used to the gun, I'll get it down here because it's not the same shape as your regular autos and stuff. But you see, they fall off, not too dirty, but I've gotten maybe 10, what, about 12 rounds through it already today. Yeah, let's, well, just three-point shoot one more time. Let's say it's 5 yards. Whatever it is, 5 yards, whatever. Two more rounds. You're walking, and the guy jumps out, and he has a knife on the gun. You say back off. Instead of trying to get it out, let's make it like, that's good enough. Let's just say he's right on top of you. You won't drop the gun. You had this in your hand already. Because if you try to get to your gun, he's coming like this. You gotta pull your gun out, boom, he got you. You can't get it out. Now I'm gonna pretend like I had this down here. But I have a hand on it, you come at me. One, two, he's dead. Cause I can engage. That's why it's a lifesaver. This is an airbag. This in your hand in the dark, I don't care if you got 50 rounds in your pocket or in your gun. You got a 50 caliber behind your back. When that comes at you like he just did, you're dead. That's what happened. One, two. And everybody always says, well, I do this and I do that. Is that right? People's never been out in the street. Just stop for a minute what you're doing. I'm gonna ask you one quick question. Because you only have 1 second to react or less, okay? 1 second to react or less. If your friends are watching this with you, I want them to watch to see what kind of answer you give, okay? No BS, this could save your life. Here we go. Okay, with all you know-it-alls, here we go. You got 1 second. What are you gonna do? Time's up, you're dead. Now we're gonna chronograph the double tap. First ones with the unported barrels. Then I'll switch barrels to the ported barrels, see how much we lose. Okay, let's give her a shot, see what happens. It's saying 598, that's hard to believe. That's with 230 grain balls. I'm gonna try that again. I don't believe that one. Try one more here. 612. That's right, 600 feet per second. Wow. Okay, now we're gonna try the ported barrel. See what speed is. With these are just standard Walmart hardballs. .617. Didn't lose zip with the ported barrel. With the 45, wow. I don't know how it could be a little faster, but it is. I better try one more of those. Let me see here. Put this on video. The 617, the highest one, was with the ported barrel. Let's try another one. As you can see, it's the ported barrel. Try one more with the ported barrel. I was going to call it a day, but one more. These are coming out kind of weird. Okay, last shot of the day, ported barrel. This isn't too bad, but my Oler 33P, I trust a lot better. Or 34P, I got both. All right, here we go. Ported barrel, standard Federal Hardpoint, red and black box Federal out of Walmart. Let's see. 621. Holy smokes. Strange circumstances, but the ported barrel is shooting faster than the non-ported. Strange as that may seem, 621 is the second shot with the ported barrel. I'm doing video with the iPhone too while I'm talking here. Unbelievable with the ported barrel. Now, I don't think that works with the 9mm. I've seen other people test it. And the ported barrel affects the velocity. But doesn't seem to make much difference. In a 45, you have less recoil. Significantly less recoil. Wow. That's a plus plus. Less recoil. Faster, well, yeah, that's faster. 21 feet per second faster. 22 feet per second faster than last time. But 600, 599, that's not going to make much difference up close and personal. When you're doing stay alive type of tactics. That's impressive.